So hi guys, I'm from the gym and yes, I'm back at the gym. I finally gave in to the peer pressure of some bodies I made in the winter. So I'm back because, you know, it's gotten a bit bigger. So I initially planned on doing a video about cleansers with acids in them, but then I just can't imagine putting something that strong on my face right now. I just simply don't feel like my skin needs it. So when I feel like my skin doesn't need anything that strong, I just simply use a gentle cleanser. So I thought it would be a good idea that we come and talk about these gentle cleansers. There's quite a few of them on the market, and I have a few of them as well in my stash. But the two that I have here is the Nivea Gentle Cream Wash and the Eucerin Dermatoclean Hyaluron Cleansing Milk. So let me show you swatches of these two products. Alright, so this is what the Eucerin looks like. This is what the Eucerin looks like, and this is what the Nivea looks like. I think many of you would have seen this at your local clicks, or it just had. Woo, my hands are so dry. My hands are so dry. Alright. This one is a... Let me step back a little. This is the Eucerin Cleansing Milk. It is a white cream. It's not as runny as the name would suggest, because when they say milk, you expect it to be a lot more looser in texture. It's not. It's a thick cream. And this is the Nivea. You won't see... My hands are so dry. You won't see the color of this, but it is a light pink, so I'm guessing there are dyes in this one. This one is called a cream, so it is true to its name. It's quite thick in consistency. All right, so on the left on the left part of my face, I'm just gonna apply a couple of squirts of this Eucerin. I always feel like I need more of this. I don't know why. I don't know, I think it's something in my brain that convinces me that these don't quite cleanse my skin. But they do, and we're going to discuss that shortly. So this is the Eucerin, and then I'm going to apply the Nivea on the right part of my face. This is how much I'm going to apply of this Nivea, and then, ooh, it's so cold, it's so cold. It's so cold, it's so cold, guys. Like, August, it'll be August if we didn't have, like, questionable weather. So let's just rub these in. Like I said, the Nivea is a lot thicker than the Eucerin. The Eucerin also is not as watery, but when you mix it, when you put water on your face, I guess it then activates the milk. It becomes a lot more looser in texture than it was on initial application. The Nivea is just like applying lotion. It's just like applying lotion, and that's the theme I'm noticing with all these milk or cream cleansers or gentle cleansers or whatever the company decides to call them. It's literally like you're applying a body cream on your face and you're using that to wash your face. So let me come close and show you. I look weird. I look so weird. I look like I'm Jimmy. This is the side with the Nivea cream. Let me reduce the light. Like, I think I struggle with these lights. I think I'm struggling with the light. I need better lighting. Guys, you're not gonna see. Let me try and step back and see if it's gonna be better. This is the side with the Nivea. As you can see, that's just an even application of the product. It's like I took Nivea cream, the one in the blue tub, and just slapped it on my face. This thing is, look at my mirror. Eucerin also has an even application of it. It's like, the only difference is like, this is a thicker cream and this one is a lighter cream. But they both feel like I'm applying lotion on my face. I've rinsed off the cleansers off of my face. This is a part, this is a side with the Eucerin. I'm not gonna come close because you're not gonna see. I think if I stand here, you're able to see better. This is the side with the Eucerin Cleansing Milk, and this is the side with the Nivea Cream Wash. You're not going to see, so we're not going to waste time doing that. Both these cleansers are very moisturizing, you guys. I could literally just stand here and talk to you the whole day and I wouldn't feel like my skin is tight or my skin needs to be moisturized immediately. It's not like any of the cleansers that I have with actives, which you normally have to just follow up with a moisturizer right away. The side with the Eucerin looks moisturized. It looks moisturized, and so does the side with the Nivea. These are the cleansers. I'm not even gonna try and break it down because both sides look the same to me anyways. These are the cleansers that you would use when, like I said, you're not looking for anything strong to use during the day, perhaps when you don't have much to remove off of your face and you just want to remove maybe last night's sweat and then put on your sunscreen quickly and go. These are the type of cleansers that you will go for. These are definitely not cleansers that you will reach for if you're looking to address specific issues with your skin, because they are not likely to help with any of those troubles. They are just gonna cleanse your skin, and the best that they can do is just keep the surface of your skin clean, and they don't have much active surfactants in them that are able to penetrate and unclog all the dirt that is accumulating in your pores and prevent any future breakouts, much like cleansers with actives are able to do. You're not gonna get that with these cleansers. Definitely one of those cleansers that people who are maybe on some medication for their skin concerns, these are the type of cleansers that those people would be using. People with very sensitive skin that reacts to absolutely everything. I use these cleansers on days like today where I've been sweating a lot and I felt like my skin was fresh and I just wanted to remove that sweat and not use anything strong that would possibly interfere with the feeling that I had on my skin, because I love that it was quite cooling, was quite refreshed. So I wanted to keep that but just remove the sweat off of my face. But you can absolutely use water if you don't have a budget for these kind of cleansers. The Nivea one is the cheapest of the two. It's also the one with fragrance, so if you have sensitive skin, you do want to be mindful of that fact. It is, I think it's 70 rands, and if it's on special you can get it for a lot cheaper than that. It is creamier when you compare it to the Eucerin. It's taken me a while to get used to it, but I quite like it and I enjoy using it in the morning. The Eucerin is gonna be the fragrance free one, and it costs I think 170, around 170, but on a special. And Eucerin is one of those brands that is always on special, you can get it for a lot cheaper. I feel like with these cleansers, you either you love them or you hate them. It's either you feel they're useless in your routine or you love them. Like I said, they have a place for me in my routine in the morning. You cannot remove sunscreen with these, well, unless of course you applied one layer of sunscreen during the day and you do not reapply, and there's not much oils there's not much oils that climb onto your skin during the day and there's not much dust, then you can use these. But if you've been piling on sunscreen and you've piled on makeup, these will not remove sunscreen, nor will they remove makeup. So I say all of that to say, if you were curious about these cleansers, if you've never used one before, now you know it's not going to do much for your skin or your skin concerns. It's just going to remove the dirt off of your face, and mild dirt at that. And if you've been using these cleansers and you felt like they were not doing anything, or they were addressing any concerns that you were having on your skin, with your skin, hyperpigmentation, excessive oiliness, you may be using these cleansers wrong. These are just basic cleansers for people with sensitive skin and people who are not wanting to do much during that step of their routine. So that is it. I love the cleansers. Will I continue to buy them? Yes. I think I'll continue to buy the Nivea though, because it's nice and thick and creamy, and you don't feel those beads when you're applying them on your face. I don't feel like it's physically exfoliating my face at all. You don't feel the beads at all. I forgot to tell you about that earlier. I think I'm gonna continue to buy the Nivea one because it's cheaper and it does the job. And then for the Eucerin, I'm gonna buy the other cleanser from this line that I like, the gel cleanser, but I'm gonna show you that much later on the channel. So these cleansers do not have actives, but I will bring you cleansers that do have actives in them that have worked for me and my hyperpigmentation and sun damage, in case you are struggling with the same issues with your skin. Thank you so much for joining me. I'm gonna jump in the bath now and move on, carry on with my day. I have work today. It's so cold. Have a good day, everybody.